This video is going to show you the natural transmutation equations for beta decay. Now, a beta particle is a high energy electron. It has a mass of pretty much zero, because it's an electron, and it has a charge of minus one. So you're either going to write it with the symbol B, or it can be an E, because it is an electron. So let's write our decay expressions. So we have iodine 131. I'm going to draw an arrow. We have to find the atomic number of iodine. So we look at the periodic table. It's 53. And then we're going to write our beta particle. Now, the beta particle is formed when a neutron kicks off a negative particle and turns into a proton. So what we're going to do here is we're just going to make sure that the mass before equals the mass after. So 131 is equal to 0 plus 131. Now this one's interesting. Remember, a neutron turned into a proton. So 53 is equal to minus 1 plus 54. The atomic number goes up because a neutron turns into a proton when it kicks off a beta minus particle. So we go back to the periodic table. We look up element number 54. It's xenon. And we're done with that natural transmutation. Now we're going to do thorium 234. Same thing. We're going to do a beta decay. I'm going to write it as an E, though, this time. Doesn't matter. They're interchangeable. Whatever is easier for you. And we look up thorium, element number 90. The mass number stays the same up top, and the atomic number goes up by 1. We look up number element number 91, promethium, Pa, and we're done. Now we got strontium 90, Sr 90. And we look up strontium, element number 38. And that's going to be 0 minus 1. I'll put the E there again. So we have 90 as our mass number and 39 as our atomic number. And that's yttrium. Y. And the last one I'm going to do is phosphorus 32. P32. Phosphorus, element number 15. And another beta decay. So I'll put a B there this time. Mass number of the new isotope is 32, atomic number 16, which means we just made sulfur 32. And that's how you do the beta decay of certain isotopes.